Hello anatomy colleagues, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the oddly named region referred to as the anatomical snuffbox. So first we will actually locate it and identify those main tendinous boundaries, and then of course we'll discuss the contents and those clinical considerations and why we need to consider this area. So the anatomical snuffbox is a depression in the posterior lateral side of the wrist, and it's most noticeable when you extend your thumb or to kind of jut it out laterally, often referred to as a hitchhiker's thumb. Now, I think we need to address the name. First off, if there was another name for this region, I would most certainly use it, or if it was commonly used, but this is what you hear this referred to as. Very occasionally you hear the term radial fossa, but this is really not caught on. Maybe we can make that happen. But it's named this because in this depression, in the past, individuals would hold snuff, which is a kind of ground up tobacco, before inhaling it in the nose, hence the name snuffbox. Not a very typical practice nowadays, but yet the name persists. So enough about the name, let's talk about the actual anatomy. This is going to be formed by long tendons of the first digit on the posterior side. So the tendon of the extensor pollicis longus, or your EPL, will form the medial border. This is usually the easiest one to see. You can see it as this kind of ridge. And then the lateral border is formed by tendons, the EPB, or the extensor pollicis brevis, and your abductor pollicis longus. Is usually a little bit deeper, so you can usually see the EPB a little bit better. Don't worry so much about remembering which one is which in terms of the tendon names, but I do want you to understand that these are long pollicis or first digit tendons. The floor of the snuffbox, which can be palpated, are two carpal bones, the scaphoid, which we'll talk a little bit more about in a moment, and the trapezium, so both on the lateral side of the carpal bones. You can also palpate the styloid process of the radius in the proximal portion of this region on deep palpation. Now, what is in this region? What are the contents? Well, arguably the most important is the radial artery. So I'm going to put a few fun stars next to it so you know that it's important. So this is going to lie in the floor of the snuffbox. And you can even feel the radial pulse here, but it isn't the most common location to get a radial pulse because it is a little deep. More common places where the radial artery lies on the anterior surface of the distal radius, so kind of just lateral to the tendon of the flexor carpi radialis. So here the artery is really only covered by skin and fascia, so a little bit easier to palpate, but you certainly can feel it within the anatomical snuffbox as well. There are some other contents that I will mention, but won't hold you accountable for, which includes a cutaneous branch of the radial nerve, which is going to end up serving some of the skin of the hand, and even the cephalic vein may pass superficially over this region. Now, before we finish, I want to focus on one of the bones that forms the floor of the anatomical snuffbox, the scaphoid, which is the most commonly fractured carpal bone. This fracture, similar to a Colles fracture, is often caused by a fall on an outstretched hand, or fouche, love to say, don't love to do, or of course, direct trauma can cause this, but that's a bit rarer. The fracture most commonly occurs on this narrowest portion of the bone, and this is important. It's often not picked up on initial imaging, say right after the injury, and it can be misdiagnosed as a severely sprained wrist, so it's difficult to see the fracture sometimes. But imaging done 10 to 14 days after the injury typically reveals the fracture because bone resorption occurs due to avascular necrosis. This bone has a very tenuous blood supply. In fact, it has retrograde blood flow, which we will discuss in more detail in the clinical and anatomical correlation session. This can cause degenerative joint disease in the wrist, as the scaphoid is an important part of the radiocarpal joint. So it's going to be one of those main bones articulating with the distal radius. Excellent. We have reached the summary slide with our big picture concepts regarding the anatomical snuffbox. Please take time to review and always feel free to reach out with any questions to myself, of course, or any of my anatomy colleagues. Thank you for your time and attention.